Throughout this series, we're going to be working at converting this mockup here into an HTML, CSS, and JavaScript template. Now, if you're just starting out with front-end development, there's a couple of words there that you might not recognize. The first is mockup. A mockup is simply a picture of how the website is supposed to look when it's complete. Most often, these mockups are built in a program called Adobe Photoshop, which we have open here. The other word I used was template. In this case, template means an HTML, CSS, and JavaScript scaffolding that you can plug different data into. For example, when this website is launched, the content that you see right here will be replaced by something more current, probably dynamic. The template, though, will stay the same. It's just that the content inside of the template will be different. As we build out our template, we'll put dummy content in there in order to fill that space and give the client a demonstration of what it might look like when there's real content in there. Now, we'll be using Photoshop in this series, but you don't need to have Photoshop in order to follow along. I'll make sure that any assets that we produce are available to you without having to go in and do it yourself. However, if you're working towards a goal of becoming a professional front-end developer, you'll need to learn Photoshop at some point. As you can see, the design is already complete here. So all we'll be doing in Photoshop is cutting out small sections of the design to use as images or as reference as we build HTML and CSS to make it look like the design. Sometimes front-end developers also take the role of designer and they design the site as well as code it. Most often though, a front-end developer takes a design that's already been created and they convert it into code. Now, this particular design that you see is carefully crafted to cover many of the more common and challenging front-end development scenarios that you would run into. If your goal is getting a job at a digital agency doing front-end development, then you might be required to take a design like this and convert it into a template as part of your application process. There's a resource pack that includes this Photoshop mockup, as well as all of the other files and resources we'll be using throughout the series. And you can download it by going to the Front End Development Series page on Build a Module and clicking the Download Resource Pack link. Once you do that and expand it, you'll see something that includes this mockups folder. You'll also see a number of other files and folders as well that we will develop as we go through this series, but this mockups folder should be there too. So in this mockups folder, you see a homepage mockup.psd, that's a Photoshop file, and you can open it up in Photoshop. But we also have a PNG file, which is basically a snapshot of the Photoshop file. You can open this in any operating system to take a look at the design, and also to use this as a source for cutting out sections of the design as we start to build our HTML and CSS. I'm going to go back to Photoshop, and I'm going to turn off these blue lines that you see going up and down. These are called guides. That way we can look at the template and also take screenshots without having these blue lines as a part of it. We'll talk more about what these blue lines are for and how this is structured in a grid a little later on in this series. So I'll go to View, Show, and I'll uncheck Guides. Then I'm going to zoom in and get it within a view here.